Hey everybody, welcome back to Taz's Wig Closet at Wig Studio One. Today I'm going to show you four styles from four different brands, all in beautiful gray blonde shades. Today were either purchased with my own funds or provided for a previous review. You can find them at Wig Studio One. Expand the description box below the video. You'll find a link that'll take you out to the product so you can look at more details and pricing for each. We invite you to shop at Wig Studio One. If there's any questions, please feel free to reach out to support at Wig Studio One or from any product page on the website. Scroll down, hit the help button to be connected with a live chat. What I'm wearing here is the John Renaud's January. It's in the color Martini, which is 101F48T. Martini by John Renaud is the first wearable gray that I found for myself. Me being a blonde lover, this has a lot of blonde notes to it. So I was very happy with that because when I look at this, I don't see just a pure gray wig. I see a very fashionable, layered, dynamic color. So this actually could go blonde or it could go gray, depending on your taste, style, and preference and how you wear your wig colors. Now, the color Martini is not a rooted color, so you're not gonna get that extra dimension of a root. I'll be showing you some rooted colors today. But Martini is basically a pearly gray-white mix. There's more of the pearlescent white around the face, I think, more highlights around the face. But it makes a dynamic blend and mix. Now, the description says that there is a light brown at the nape. Now, that could be arguable. To me, it looks, on this particular piece and application of this color, it kind of looks like a dark ash blonde. So the next three kind of gray blondes have rooting on them. So there's a big difference in how each manufacturer does their rooting and how the rooting appears. So I'll go ahead and change into the next style. So here I am wearing the Henry Margoux's Athena in their brand new color, 60101GR. Now the GR just stands for gradient colors, meaning that they are rooted, so you're gonna see a nice transition from the root out to the main body of the color. Now the 60101 is an amazing color. So this color really does start with a light, subtle silver blonde. And it just appears as though it's kind of a white with a toner on it. It doesn't really appear gray at all. It just has hints of silver in it based on the tone, the ashy tone of that white. And then all of that is highlighted with platinum. Okay, so it's a white platinum blend, but the way they've toned the white, it does give it a little bit of silvery appearance. And all of that is on a medium brown root. Now that root, for several reasons, I think it looks very soft and natural. It's a medium golden brown, but they take the highlight color right up to the root. Every other knot or so, it's dispersed beautifully and perfectly. Okay, so let's bring on our third style. So here I'm wearing the Aesthetica's Winter in the color Silver Sun RT8. There's a lot going on here too, although this one, just off of first glance, it kind of looks like a platinum that's been toned. So there's really officially no gray in this, okay? It's an icy platinum, which means they've taken a platinum, I think, and they've toned it down a little bit. It gives a little bit of a bluish, grayish tint to it. And then what you're going to find in there also is a bit of highlight of a pale sandy, like a pale sandy blonde. And that gives it some depth and dimension. So it's just not a one note toned down icy platinum here. It's kind of a sandy beigey highlight note to it. Just a very whisper of warmth it injects into this, but this is still a cool, icy, as ashy as it gets, kind of a toned down platinum look. And this one has a medium brown root. That brown root is very stark in contrast to this color. I think that it would have been great if some highlight could have been added there at the lace front and at the root. think that it really would soften it. And this one has more of a demarcation there, line. So it looks like a stark regrowth. Okay, last but not least. So I'm back with that last color that I'm gonna present, this kind of a blonde silver. Beltress has come out with some of the most beautiful colors that I have seen on wigs. They're so thoughtful, multi-tonal, tons of layering of color and dimension. So this is a combination of like a light silver blonde. There is kind of a neutral pale blonde in there. And a little bit of light ash blonde. All right, so a combination of some kind of icy silver blonde, a neutral pale blonde, and a pale ash blonde. Again, using so many colors. You look at the Beltress color codes sometimes if they're available and they're like that long. I love that. I love that because it just makes this dynamic look like it's like a baking a cake with all the ingredients come together. It's perfect. And that's how I feel about this color. And you want to know the best part? There is a very subtle rooting effect here. So again, this is Beltress's Amaretto in Rocca Margarita Blonde. Okay, so that's it. Those are the four styles and colors. We're going to do a side-by-side comparison next. Everybody have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time on Taz's Wig Closet at Wig Studio One.